When Fred Wiseman, a mechanic, auto racer, and a bit of a daredevil, heard about the Wright brothers' flight, he visited them. Apparently, he took notes, because after that visit, he built his own version of their historic aircraft, which he then proceeded to fly in demonstrations throughout Northern California. At 12:30 p.m. on Friday, February 17, 1911, Fred, after being delayed by bad weather, departed Petaluma's Kenilworth Park, bound for Santa Rosa. Just a few minutes after his departure, just 4 miles north of his takeoff, Fred was forced to land due to a problem with the engine's magneto. He spent that night in a muddy field working to repair the engine and fix a broken skid. At 9:05 a.m. the following morning, he took off again for Santa Rosa on a makeshift runway made of canvas sheeting. 10 miles and 10 minutes later, a broken wing brace wire forced Fred to land in a field near the Entz Dairy Ranch, just a mile short of the Santa Rosa fairgrounds. The brace wire had gotten caught in his propeller and caused the engine to seize up. Friends who were following Fred's flight in a car picked him up and drove him the remainder of the distance to the fairgrounds, where he received what was described at the time as a hero's welcome. What made that flight auspicious was that Fred carried the first official United States airmail. In addition to 3 historic letters, one of which was written by the Petaluma postmaster to the Santa Rosa postmaster, Fred also carried a sack of coffee and several copies of the Press Democrat. On May 15, 1947, Fred's flight was recognized by the Smithsonian Institution as America's first airmail flight. The Smithsonian's curator at the time and its founder, Dr. Paul Garber, stated that Fred's flight was the first airplane-carried mail flight officially sanctioned by a U.S. postmaster and made available to the public. Good job, Fred.